Get ready for the dictation. Start. Sir, section 115 of the Code of Civil Procedure has been amended so as to take away the power of revision of the High Courts against questioning orders. This revision was causing a lot of inconvenience to the litigant against questioning orders filed in courts which are pending for years and the suits are being stayed. This has been taken out, of course. The power of revision of the High Courts is there where no appeal lies. I fully endorse this amended clause about judgment. A new clause has been introduced. The judgments should be delivered within a fortnight of the closing of the hearing of the case. If that is not possible with notice to the parties, it should be done within 30 days. This is very salutary. If the court finds that it is not possible to deliver the judgment within 30 days, this is very salutary. If the court finds that it is not possible to deliver the judgment within 30 days for reasons to be recorded in writing, it can postpone the delivery of the judgment to a subsequent date, giving notice to the parties. Therefore, the purpose of the amendment would not be served ordinarily in cases where the judge has to give notice to parties of judgment at a later date, and I do not think the litigant will be benefited. I am glad that another new order has been added which gives the party, the litigant, the cost incurred by him prior to the filing of the suit. It is a good thing. Previously, the plaintiff who obtained a decree could not get the cost incurred by him prior to the filing of the suit. Now this has been included. It is a good improvement. Under this provision, in such family suits, the courts shall try to settle them before the trial begins. It is a good thing in family matters, like a husband filing a suit for judicial separation or the wife filing a suit for maintenance. There the courts will come to the aid of the parties, and in camera they could try to settle and see that they could come together. In most cases, the courts will succeed in seeing that parties come to an understanding without undergoing the trouble of lending evidence on either side. Similar provision should be made where the subject matter of the suit does not exceed ₹3,000. We have limited the right of appeal to suits where the subject matter is more than ₹3,000. Sir, similar provision should be thought of here also, so that the court would come to the rescue of the persons and see that the matter is settled. Now, the position is that assistance of lawyer would be given to the plaintiff. The High Court is authorized to frame rules as it deems fit, but God alone knows when the High Court will frame such rules. Legal aid should not be taken as only an assistance of a lawyer. Now you are giving assistance of only lawyer to plaintiff who is needy. But what about defendant who is also equally poor? I am not talking about poor defendants. He is equally needy and he should be entitled to legal assistance. This, of course, comes within the purview of legal aid. There is also another proposal in the amending bill that case which has been brought should be disposed of within 60 days. Under the election law, election petitions are required to be disposed of within 6 months, but they are never disposed of within 6 months. They take years, so it is only a pious wish. Much time is taken up in serving notice of the appeal on the respondents. So, though it is a good thing, I doubt whether this will be achieved. Sir, none of the objects for which the amending bill has been brought forward can be achieved by this amending bill. But the bill is helpful in one respect. It has streamlined the procedure. It has removed doubts. It has removed conflict of judicial decisions by codifying the law. On legal aid, the question is how the litigant can have expensive justice and also speedy justice. Court fees have become major source of revenue for each state government, and every year they raise court fees. It is impossible for the litigant to pay such high court fees. The law minister told us that last year he had written to chief ministers about it, but there has been no effect so far. When I spoke on law ministry's demands this year, I said that court fees should be kept within reasonable limits and that they should not be raised. Administration of justice is also a function of a state which is a welfare state. Another way of imparting inexpensive and speedy justice is to decentralize the courts. Courts should be established at each block headquarters so that the litigant will not be compelled to take the witnesses to the nearby cities. The witness is the major source of expenditure for the litigants because witness has to be treated like an honored guest. Stop. Hello Southandians, welcome to my YouTube channel. ऐसे ही और हार्ड वर्ड्स की आउटलाइन और वर्ड्स डिफ्रेंसिएशन की वीडियोस के लिए प्लीज़ वीडियो को लाइक शेयर और चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें एंड डोंट फॉरगेट टू प्रेस द बेल आइकन. थैंक यू.